Over the course of 10 years, the cast of the Harry Potter films, based on the books by controversial author J.K. Rowling, spent countless hours on set, leaving them with some incredible lasting memories. But not every moment was as exciting or fun as it seemed on screen. In a two-part series, we will be showing you some of the things that the cast loved and hated about making the movies. We will be saving the best for the last, so we will begin with what they hated. Number 1. Radcliffe wasn't a fan of his Quidditch scenes. Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2, the final film in the franchise, reached theaters on July 15, 2011, and with rumors of adapting the Harry Potter and the Cursed Child for the big screen, fans will surely be feeling very excited about the idea. But its titular star, Daniel Radcliffe, isn't nostalgic about the magical trappings of some of his roles in the 8-part movie. Well, according to some of the things he says he will not miss, Daniel Radcliffe has said many times over the years that filming Quidditch scenes was his least favorite part of Harry Potter experience, and he was relieved when Quidditch wasn't part of the last two films.
Welcome to your first flying lesson.
It's not a pleasant experience. It does hurt quite a lot, and it's not something I would rush back to, Radcliffe said in an interview. But he doesn't have anything else to complain about, so Quidditch was the low point, and you can take everything else as being the high point, he said. Number 2. Emma dreaded having to grow up under filmmakers. At the world premiere in London of Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2, Emma Watson said that she learned a great deal about being an actress on the set during her time with the film franchise, but admitted that sometimes the experience stifled her freedom. Not a single second of the day was in my power. I was told what time I'd be picked up, what time I could eat, and when I could go to the bathroom. I have spent more of my life being someone else than I have been myself. I've always had a strong sense of who I am and what I want, but I do need to spend more time figuring that out. Number 3. Rupert doesn't miss the red carpet. Rupert Grint told The Guardian that he felt a bit lost after finishing all the Harry Potter films, but there was one aspect of the experience that he certainly did not miss. The whole press and red carpet thing was an attack on the senses. I don't excel in that kind of environment. Number 4. Maggie Smith did not feel challenged. In 2019, Maggie Smith said she enjoyed that her grandchildren were so thrilled she starred in the Harry Potter films, but she didn't feel personally challenged by the role as Professor Minerva McGonagall. The actress also revealed that she wasn't too keen on sitting around in McGonagall's wardrobe waiting for her scenes. "I used to find the most exhausting thing was wearing those hats," she said. "They're the heaviest things in the world. I had a hat, it was like the Albert Hall, it was huge and so heavy." The actress continued, "I was in the snow for about a week with that daft hat on my head for Harry Potter and sitting in the trailer day after day and not being used. That doesn't make you feel too jolly." Number 5. Alan Rickman believes Snape deserved more. After actor Alan Rickman, who played the role of Severus Snape, passed from pancreatic cancer in 2016, a collection of his personal papers was sold at an auction. The collection included a letter from Harry Potter producer David Heyman that suggested Rickman was not happy about Snape's development early on in the series. "Thank you for making HP2 a success. I know, at times, you are frustrated, but please know that you are an integral part of the film, and you are brilliant." And in a note, Rickman himself wrote during the filming of Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince, titled Inside Snape's Head, he expressed a similar concern. "It's as if David Yates has decided that this is not important in the scheme of things, that is, teen audience appeal." Number 6. Michael Gambon hated the wig and the makeup. Michael Gambon told Scotland's The Herald that although he tends to forget a lot of the films he's done, he does remember the costumes. That includes his Albus Dumbledore attire and look for the Harry Potter films. "I remember Harry Potter because of the costume. Richard Harris, who played Dumbledore in the first two scripts, wore great big heavy robes, really heavy, but I wore just silk, just two layers of silk and carpet slippers, so it was the most comfortable job. The only problem is the wig and the makeup, which is quite time consuming. Number 7. Jason Isaacs didn't like being Lucius Malfoy. Although many fans consider Jason Isaacs perfect as the icy, arrogant Lucius Malfoy, the actor originally wanted to play a different character, Gilderoy Lockhart. Isaacs said that he was already planning to play Captain Hook in the upcoming film Peter Pan and didn't want another role as a villain. "I didn't audition for Lucius, I auditioned for a Gilderoy Lockhart. I was mighty pissed off when they asked me would I mind reading for a different part. I went back in and read, then went home. I said to my agent, when they call, tell them no, thank you very much. I am about to go play Captain Hook. It's fun and lovely and flattering, but I'm not playing two children's villains. Isaac's family, however, convinced him otherwise. They all tried to persuade me to take the job, not because they cared about me, but because they wanted to visit the set. So I took the job, and thank God I did. Number 8. Helena Bonham felt terrible about hurting Neville. Helena Bonham Carter, who said her character Bellatrix Lestrange was bonkers as they come, told Entertainment Weekly that she feels terrible about hurting Neville, Matthew Lewis, while filming the Deathly Hallows scene in the Department of Mysteries, in which she threatens him with her wand. "I did something terrible by mistake. I poked him in his ear. I thought I could brandish the wand like a sort of Q-tip and clean out his ear, sort of torture it. But unfortunately, he moved towards the wand and I was prodding it, and it actually perforated his eardrum. Isn't that horrific? I damaged him. He's such a nice young man. He didn't admit to me that he actually had some internal bleeding about 3 days later." Number 9. Tom Felton didn't like his dyed hair. Tom Felton's natural hair color is brown, so he had to dye it frequently to be transformed into the bleach blonde Draco Malfoy. Felton said at the news conference in 2008 he wouldn't miss that part of the filming of Harry Potter series. "The worst thing was dyeing my hair blonde. It built some superhuman resistance, but it seems to have survived." Number 10. Bonnie Wright being in the public eye during adolescence. Bonnie Wright, just 9 years old when she first played Ginny Weasley in the films, said growing up on and off screen in such a public way as an adolescent wasn't easy, and she was glad that for the most part social media wasn't as prevalent as it is now. "It's not fun when you're a teenager and experiencing those things. You're growing into yourself and see photos of yourself like, oh god, especially when you're changing so much every year." Number 11. Matthew Lewis didn't like wearing prosthetics as a teenager. As Neville Longbottom, actor Matthew Lewis had to wear a fat suit in 4 of the films and false teeth in 2. He told Entertainment Weekly, "I didn't mind it until I was 14 or 15, and then there were girls on set. I was a bit like, why me?" Number 12. Imelda Staunton didn't like torturing Harry as Dolores Umbridge. In a 2016 interview with EW, Imelda Staunton, Dolores Umbridge, said she dislikes her character as much as fans do. "I love doing it," she said, "but I have to say the most difficult scene to do, which did leave me feeling pretty bad for a couple of days, was actually the scene where I make Harry do the lines and it happens in his hand." She continued, "That touched into something that you think, gosh, we're all capable of great cruelty. It was horrible, horrible feeling."